Hello everyone. Today, we'll learn how to create a true-false question. This type of questions has only two answer choices. Users have to choose one from them in response to a statement of the question. To insert a true-false question, in the Interactions tab, click TrueFalse. And a new question slide appears on the canvas. The question has three parts: question title, answer choices, feedback messages, and button. Type or paste the question title into the title section. By default, the answer choices are true and false. You can change them to yes, no, or right, wrong if you want. To define the correct answer of the question, double-click the radio button of the answer. Besides, note that these buttons are formattable. Select them, open the Format tab, and choose the button style you like. Answer choices are arranged vertically on the canvas with one column and the default spacing. You can customize them the way you like from the Group Layout section of the Properties pane. With the Grid mode, you are not allowed to freely change the object position on the canvas. To do that, you have to use the None mode here. For more information about the question layout, see the video Group Layout of Questions. ActivePresenter enables you to set the score and reporting for the question. You can find them in the Score and Reporting section of the Properties pane. This is helpful especially when you need to track the result of online learners. Remember to select the graded mode first, then select the number of points for each correct answer from the points list. And say the max attempts that learners can take before the object is disabled. The timeout options is used to specify the time limit. If learners don't respond within the defined time limit, objects will be disabled. Besides, if you want to shuffle the answer choices of the question, select this option. Now, I'll show you how to add events and actions to the question. Select the question, go to the Events, Actions section of the Properties pane. As you can see, a true-false question in ActivePresenter comes with default events and actions that are ready to use. For example, if learners have a correct answer, a correct message appears and the presentation continues. However, you can change these properties as you wish. For example, you can add one more action to play a short audio music when learners answer correctly. For more information on this, see the video Working with Events, Actions. With some types of actions such as Show Object, you have more options for hiding and blocking objects. When the object contains long text that requires viewers more time to read, you should change this hide after value. Besides, you can block the subsequent actions until the currently showing action is completed. Otherwise, subsequent actions will be executed right after the object is displayed. The feedback messages and button are added by default and ready to use. You can still change them. However, you have to do that in the Slide Master view. Open the View tab, and click Slide Master. Then, you can edit them as normal. Feedback messages are placed coincidentally. If you don't want each of them to have a different style, select and format them at once. Along with the automatically added Submit. You may want to have some more buttons like the Next or Back. In the Slide Master view, insert a button, then add events and actions to it. However, the common practice is to copy and paste the button to create new ones. I'm creating a back button to bring learners back to the previous slide. After all the changes, close the Slide Master view to save them. Click Slide Master, and click Close Master view. You can refer to the video Working with Slide Master for more information. Now, let's preview the result. That's what you have to know to create a true, false question. Hope that helps. Bye for now.